Hello everyone, welcome to another video lesson, and today I'm going to talk about one of the greatest diaries of all time, Samuel Pepys. Well, the diary of Samuel Pepys is an important section that comes under unit 1 of Kerala set syllabus, and it has been asked several times in the exam as well. So in this class I'm going to give you some important facts regarding the diary of Samuel Pepys. Now first, let's understand what a diary is. It is a daily written record of one's experiences and feelings and observations. And a diary is a literary form that emerged in the second half of the 17th century. And during this period, there was an increasing popularity of diary as a personal document in England. Now, if you look at Samuel Pepys' diary, you will get to know that it is not all about his personal revelations, but it is a detailed account of history's greatest happenings. Now, in his diary, he gives a clear picture of what life was like in England during 1660s. And you all know that 1660 to 1700 is marked as a restoration period in England. Isn't it? The Restoration England is brought to life through the pages of Samuel Pepys' diary. Now, even historians found it very interesting, and they have been using Samuel Pepys' diary to get a better understanding of London during this era. Now, Samuel Pepys made his first diary entry on 1st January 1660, and he continued till 1669. And as I pointed out earlier, his diary deals with some of the dramatic events in England. So let me take you through the first incident that occurred during that period, and it is a coronation of Charles II. Now, Charles II was defeated by Oliver Cromwell at the Battle of Worcester in 1651, following which Charles escaped to France. But after Oliver Cromwell's death in 1658, Charles II was brought to the throne. Thus, military rule under Oliver Cromwell ended and monarchy was restored. That is, Charles II became the monarch of England. And this is the reason why the period from 1660 to 1700 is named as the Restoration Period. And Samuel Pepys was a witness to the coronation of Charles II, and he chronicled this ceremony in his diary. A second major event that Samuel Pepys recorded in his diary is a great plague of London that began in 1665. He recorded the weekly death tolls in his diary. He even expressed his shock on how a street that was once crowded turned out to be completely deserted. The houses were shut up. Now, shut up is a term used by his contemporaries instead of quarantine. And he even mentioned how his friends and colleagues moved from the crowded city that was plague-stricken to countryside, hoping that it would save them from this fatal disease. But the fact is that Samuel Pepys remained in the city. He stayed back during this adverse times. Now, the third event that Samuel Pepys recorded in his diary is the Great Fire of London. Now, soon after the Great Plague, London faced a major crisis, and that is the Great Fire of London in 1666. And this major incident had an incredible impact on London and its people. Now, in his diary, Samuel Pepys gave a description of how the fire continued for 4 days and nights and the destruction caused by it. He even added how people escaped in boats on the Thames River. One interesting fact that Samuel Pepys recorded in his diary is that as the fire approached his house, he quickly dug a hole and buried his wine and cheese along with other possessions. Now, this cheese that from Italy was considered valuable, but thankfully his house survived the fire. So apart from these three major events, Samuel Pepys had also made an account of a war that happened during this period. So it is up to you to find out the name of this war and leave the answer in the comment section. So that comes to the end of the session. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, do it fast so that you get notified every time I upload a video. Thanks for watching.